Hello, I'd like to talk about this app. This is a general reservations app. So it's based on the client actually having an app and they can reserve time slots at this point in time. So it's based on a hairdresser or a barber's app. It could be used for a beauty salon or a nail boutique or something like that, for a spa, massage, those sorts of things, for coaching. If you've got a gym and people want to book a coach for a specific time period so that they can actually have one-on-one training, it could be for teaching or tuition. So if you've got some students who are working through maths and they want some extra support on something like calculus, they could actually book in a one-on-one Zoom meeting or something like that with people and go through. It could also be used as a function spaces. It could be used for hot desking. It could be used for meeting rooms, even to the point of something like a garage, where you actually have garage and your or even a car wash a location where or something that where you're using it at regular intervals, and they can actually give you promotions and stuff like that. So I base it on booking in, so you actually have to log in, so therefore we can actually get your address, we can get your information. Now I'm booking in on this one here with public and email, so what this means is that somebody can give and share this to somebody else and they can just log in with an email, but it only captures email. Now I based it, my philosophy on this one here is that the staff will get the email and they will give the rest of the information. So they get the first name, the last name, so the full name is just a concatenation of the first two, who the preferred provider for the services that they actually have, what's their preferred services, and then maybe you can add another one of possible services of interest to look at on selling and possible targeting if you're going to do some promotions or things like that. Then they could actually have preferential contacts. They like to be contacted by text or phone or emails or things. We're trying to tailor something so that the customer feels it's an interface that works for them. So we're trying to offer as many things that make them comfortable. But we also want the staff to be in control of a lot of the information. So all they start with is when people log in, all you actually have is just the email. So you've got to populate it with this other information as well. Now you don't see phone numbers on here, because if I tried putting a phone number in here, and in New Zealand we start with 021, 0233, it starts off with the 21. So I could actually do that as a string, bang that as a string, and then I'll be able to put the O in the front of that. But just to make sure that it works in Glide, I've actually got inside the data panel a somewhere along here, we'll actually have one which has got a phone number on anyway. It's not particularly on that one, but it'll be on clients through there. And you'll see we have the phone number. So since that one there is actually a phone number, we make sure that the phone number is in the right configuration. Therefore, it presents properly inside the app. Therefore, we can actually text to that phone number, or we can actually just use it to actually fire off and ring that number straight away. So that information is in there. So let's just put it in properly. And to control that, we'll have the staff putting it in rather than actually coming in, having a form, client has to fill that out and then start messing around with that. Now, again, because this is front-facing app, anybody can hand it on to somebody else. So therefore, somebody can make an appointment, but you're not having any information. So you just get welcome blank because they don't have anything and it's their first time. And then if they miss the appointment or whatever, all you actually have is their email as a contact. So from the best way, if I was going to do this, is maybe to look at allowed email whitelist. So therefore, only the people on the list that you actually choose will be people who can log into their app. So that will be important if later on you actually go into a paid app, so you can actually, in the app, you can pay yourself. I haven't gone there. I've sort of tended to leave it open. My attitude with these sorts of things was leave it open. See, generally I find people are very reasonable. You do get a few people who are a bit unreasonable, but generally people do this in good faith. So you'd have it such that I'd leave it open, and then if there was a popularity of it, and then I'll start doing in-app purchases and things like that. So I wouldn't start that way myself. Anyway, we'll just go through the real estate. So at the top, you can have the logo. You've got your business name. You've got your business mission or whatever, or some statement through here. You're welcoming the person who's coming through. Through here, we've got the upcoming bookings. Now, the max has obviously just been with B at this point in time. So if we go through and click on that booking that's coming up on the 28th of August, it's with B, it's at 2 p.m., it's a beard lineup, it's for an hour, and it's going to cost $18. And it's for Max Drake. Now, I'm just going to go through and do another appointment quickly with Abby. Now, I'm going to do one on Monday, and I'm going to do one at 9 a.m., and I'm going to select something which is, and just submit that through there. And if we just come back, we now actually have an appointment with Abby. Now, now look at that one. That one's actually in there. I didn't mean to get that one. There are ones where I've actually given a start date, where the start date is later than the day that you can actually book. So therefore, you may need to contact them. So what I actually just want to demonstrate through here is when we've actually got the appointment, along with that, we've got all of the information of the client as well. So from the point of view, this is the client one, so we wouldn't actually be showing this information, although it might be handy to actually have their details just so they say, oh no, my number's changed. Sorry, I better just inform you of that bit of information. Is that this would be on the staff side of things. So when they look at that appointment and they suddenly say, well, actually, you booked too early for that particular one, and it's correct on this one, they can actually just text and say, do you actually want to change to when the actual promotion is actually happening, or do you want to pay full price? The other thing which I, from that, when I was exploring this with overthinking stuff, is that I wouldn't actually have a start date. I would actually just have a promotion from a day before today to make sure that nobody can underbook it, so that they're always falling in. If they try booking after the end of the appointment, then you've just got to ring them up and say, no, not, that's gone past. You can get it in this period. Or maybe you just say, yes, we do it. So there's a price in there. So it's very clear. So there's no ambiguity. If they go and choose, sorry, let's just go and choose that. That's a men's head shave. So if we go through, just as an example, through that one there again, and we'll just choose another day, the 1st of September, and we'll go 10 o'clock, and we'll go men's head shave through there, and we just submit that one through. We go back to the home screen. We see we've got the second one, and that is for $30. So the first one, which is under the promo there, we've got done for half price. Wow, cool. So the net that's the point of where when the person comes in straight away, you've got your branding, you're welcoming the person, you've got all of their upcoming appointments straight away. So if they look at that and they suddenly saying, oh bugger, I can't actually make that, I've now got a problem with that, they can quickly just shoot further down to Abby and actually text, ring him, email him, and just say, look, I can't make that appointment. Can you adjust it to another day? In which case, the staff can actually set that appointment to another time and free up that other period. If it's within too close a period of time, as in, it's an hour before or a day before, and they're not likely to be able to sell that time slot. Inside the sign-in, there is for the pro users a user agreement. So you can actually have a user agreement of when they sign in that they say if they do an appointment and if they step away from that appointment before, 2 days or something like that, they will incur all the fees or a fixed amount. So with the pro ones, you can actually do that as well. The other one that, as I said, with this one, you are getting the staff to put all of this information in through here. If you actually want to be comfortable about the whole thing, you go to a whitelist, and that will be in the pro version as well. This is public with the email at this point in time, and that's how I'd started off, just to test to see how the app actually went. And if you found that people were abusing it a bit, then you'd actually start tightening it up and do some things. So the next point's the promotions. There's a promotion through here. I've only shown one just to show a little bit of the information on it and also to get an image. To see them all, there's a click. So that's just an inline list, and there's three actual ones there. There's an image, there's a bit of what it is, and there's all the time frames, etc. So that comes through there. The next part is an about, the services. So with the next part, with the services, and you can do favorites. If you have favorites, you can filter them out. So while having your hair done or something like that, you can actually explore what other services that they have, and suddenly saying, oh, you know, I'm interested in the hair coloring, you know, or highlight coloring or something or other. What can we do about that? So you can actually discuss with that. Because there's 33 items through there, there's a lot to scroll through. You can actually scroll through by something like if you're doing a shampoo or something like that. So you've got your favorites, you've got them all, and you can actually use the services to do the filter. So that's in there as well. And then we've got the about of Abe, and this will be a picture of this particular person, a bit of information about them, also maybe some of his specializations or some other little bits that he actually wants to do. You've got his contact details straight away on that front page. The same with the second person. There's also a little bit of a story about the actual business that you can do, just for people's interest to do that. And then at the bottom, there's the actual contact and look at the location of the place. There's the contact phone numbers, just general ones, or maybe to one specific person, and then email and the web page and all of that, and the map, which if you click on will take you to Google Maps. So if you're running late for an appointment, you can actually look at the traffic situation to see if you're going to get there in time, and to see if they can say if they're maybe going to be 10-15 minutes late, you can ring up or tell them they're going to be late, and then you can go and push it, and at least you've tried to do the best you can. So those are all on the front page. So the second one that I've actually done as a tab, so nice, simple, comes through most of the information that you want there to actually do the bookings. I've got a separate tab just for services because they're important. And then when you come to the booking, you come through and you've got the date. You've got the date starting from today going forward. You choose the date that you actually want. You choose the time that you actually want. All you need to do is choose the service that you want. Apart from that, you can just submit it because you've logged in, we've got all your data already. So there's no need to actually give any further information. You can add a further bit of information if there's something you wanted specifically. And the other thing which I could add here is an image picker so that you can upload an image. So you've got a certain style of a mohawk or something that you actually want, and you've got a photo of it, you can upload it that so that when you come to get your hair done, you've got that image there ready to, and the staff have actually already seen it. But because I'm trying to make it as general as possible, I actually haven't put that image picker in there. I've actually kept that out because that only pertains to things like a barbershop or thing. So I've set these on an hour's interval. The other thing with this is that once we've actually chosen our allocation of whatever we want and we submit it, done, that time disappears completely. In the previous one that I'd done, when you came through, you required to actually choose some of the things along the way, and I think there was name and stuff that you actually had to fill in, and I had a switch down the bottom that you actually had to hit the switch and then you submitted. If you didn't hit the switch and then you submitted, that time slot would still be showing, so there's potential for double bookings, and that really bothered me. So I've made sure now once you've actually chosen something, you've got it. Once that you hit that submit button, it's a one button, so there's no extra thought about it. That one's safely away. Nobody else can access that. The only person who can access that now are the staff on the sheet itself through here. So I've set up per hour, but these can be set up for half hours. You could end up with a three quarters of an hour interval. You can end up with some half hour intervals, and you can end up with some hour and maybe three quarter. You can end up with times from 6 a.m. in the morning through to 10 or 12. So we can alter all of these, and I will, inside the template, inside the sheet, there will be a link to a video which will go through and display how the actual app was built so that you can actually modify it to actually suit your personal needs as to how you want to develop that app. Because as I said, I'm trying to make it general enough so that it can be used for a number of different circumstances. The other thing that I actually have on here is the chat. Now, I don't use chat, but because you're logged in straight away, you can actually chat straight the way through here on us. Maybe there's some particular feature or something that everybody's just discussing at this point in time that you can actually add your items to it. I put it in there as a tab just because it's within the Glide framework, but it's not something I'd use. I'd actually just use the texting or the thing, but it's there, so it's available. So I hope that's maybe a tool that you may consider using. I can see that it could be useful in a number of different areas as a straight reservation app. I haven't put the costing onto it so that there's in-app purchases and things like that. I'm going to try and look at an app template that works from the staff side, so that when they look in there, they've got an indication of how much is happening. Also, again, like from here, a lot of this information is exposed, so it's accessible very quickly for them to go through if something happens through there. Now, another thing with the dates I want to talk about through here as well. Inside here, when we've got the dates, we've got the dates going forward. Now, at the moment, now all of this one here has generally got weekdays, so I was basing it on a Monday to Friday, but you see there's a Sunday there, and if we just go into the other one through here, this one actually has Saturdays and Sundays. They're very easy to take out. Also, if there are holidays, you know, like Thanksgiving or Labor Day or something like that, those days could be taken out if you wanted to make sure that those don't. If somebody was actually having a holiday or they were going away for 2 days or something, they can actually take those days out so that they're not available to people to book on. And then if they go into there and there's already a couple of bookings, again, they can go in, they can find those people's contact details for those bookings. They can't do it through this one, they'd actually have to do it through the staff app. But they could then contact those people and say, look, I'm not available on those days now. I'm sorry, something has come up. Can I pass you over to my associate? They've got these times available on that day, or can I offer you an alternative day and readjust their bookings accordingly? So I want it to be a very useful app and something that's transportable and modifiable from that point of view. So again, if something like you've got this app that you want to use for maybe weekend booking for a kennel club or all sorts of things, it's an activity that you've got. It allows people to do the booking and they're totally in control of that booking. But at the same point in time, the staff or the people who are managing the app on the other side have got a lot of the information, a lot of the contact, so they can respond and adjust things quite easily without too much effort or not wasting too much time. So I hope you consider using this template, and if you'd like anything else, please contact me. And I think my email's there. Oh, there it is. So, yes, thank you very much for watching.